Okay, so we had solved quite a few questions of NPV and IRR yesterday. Some people are still very new to those concepts who were absent yesterday. That's my humble request. I'm going to anyway upload all the sessions by end of the day today. You should everyone go through that. If I tell you the conceptual difference between the two, we are just going to compare these two methods. And then we'll go to one more method of capital budgeting. So basically, what does this IRR and NPV stand for? NPV tells you that at particular rate of return, whether the project satisfies your requirement or not. And IRR tells you that what is the exact rate of return you have got from the project. That is a simple layman understanding of these two methods. Both considers time value of money, obviously, because you do the discounting of cash inflows in the IRR as well, in the NPV too. IRR can also be stated like what is the compounding rate of return you have got from the project is also an IRR. So at whatever the point of time you realize whatever the cash inflows and outflows, what is the compounded rate of return you have received from that project? That is also IRR. IRR also involves discounting. NPV also involves discounting. In both the values, in both the methods, we first find the present values in one column, yes or no. We are aware about it. In fact, IRR is dependent on the NPV only, because that's what we are taking into consideration for finding the IRR. Now, some fundamental differences. IRR is in a percentage form, obviously, because it's a rate of return you get. Now, because of the fact that it is in a percentage form, it's quite easy for understanding. It may be understood by even a layman, you know, that if you just tell that I have got 12% compounded rate of return from this project, it may be pretty much understood. But if you tell someone that you have received the NPV of 2,745, hence the project will be accepted, then non-finance person will not be able to understand this. So percentage form is pretty much understood by everyone. That's why IRR is simple to interpret, simple to analyze, and known to even laymen. For IRR, you do not require any discounting rate, because IRR itself is a discounting rate. But to find the NPV, first you should have the discounting rate, then only you can find the NPV. No, until and unless you do not have the percentage required rate of return, how can you find NPV? It's not possible. So discounting rate is not required for finding the IRR, because discounting rate itself is the IRR. That's what we are supposed to find in IRR, right? But as I already told you that IRR sometimes ignores the magnitude of scale, because it's in a percentage form. If I tell you that Chandula Limited has earned the percentage return of 10% and Reliance Industries Limited has earned the percentage return of 9.5%, then can you say that Chandulal is performing better than Reliance? No, because you are ignoring the magnitude of scale, the scale at which the operations are carried. So possibly the IRR may be very good, very attractive for some projects, but if you compare the absolute amounts, then IRR may not be comparable. So NPV is something which takes into account the relative size of the project. If you come to know that the NPV is say 1.5 crores and another project's NPV is say 20 lakhs, the magnitude of scale of NPV is pretty much clear, right? Now, possibly that 1.5 crores of NPV wala project may give you 9% IRR and 20 lakhs wala project may give you 11% IRR. So on the IRR front, maybe 20 lakhs wala project is more attractive, but if you consider the absolute scale of the business, the scale at which, the magnitude at which these operations are carried, the relative size of the project, then 1.5 crores is quite bigger than 20 lakhs, right? So NPV is the only method which gives you the amount, which gives you the answer in amount. That's why it is widely followed, because after some extent, the returns are always diminishing. That's been observed everywhere. More and more operations of scale you have, no, the percentage return reduces. You can imagine that if Reliance is having the turnover of 3 lakhs crores or 4 lakhs crores, then you cannot expect 30-40% of profitability margin in Reliance, right? Even if they have 8-10% profitability margin, that is amazing. Because at that scale, the percentage return is always reducing in nature, diminishing in nature. Higher and higher scale you operate, the percentage margin reduces. Those who are there into some wholesale business, you people are aware that, right? A 15 kg tel ka dibba will hardly have 5 to 10 rupees of margin. Do you know this Singtel tel which you people are purchasing somewhere at 2000 or 2200, carrying just the margin of 5 to 10 rupees at the wholesale market? Even for the retailers, I don't think margin would be bigger than 10 to 15. So those people who are there into oil business will be able to understand it. So at the wholesale level, at the distribution level, manufacturing level, the higher and higher scale you have for trading, lower and lower margin is going to be, right? So at that level, the percentage requirement might not be too much. But if you consider the absolute amount, then 1.5 crores of profit is quite big. So relative size of the project is taken into account in NPV, which is ignored by rest every capital budgeting techniques. Now, possibly, if I give you one example, say you people have studied the project life cycle. Now, in a project life cycle, in the earlier stage, when the company is growing, possibly you may have to follow a different discounting rate. And then once the company's product reaches to a saturation level, your rate of requirement suddenly gets raised. And in the diminishing stage, when the product or brand is not performing well and in amount of sales or in percentage profitability, when it is diminishing, the required rate of return may also be reduced. So you may have a different percentage requirement for the different time horizons of your project. That project may be a new brand, the project may be a new product, that project may be as simple as, you know, buying a furniture or buying a machinery. The nature of project could be anything which involves the extensive capital outlays. So if you have the different required rate of returns for the different time horizons, then NPV can be useful to you, because NPV, we also saw in the last lecture that you may have two or more discounting rates as well. So for the initial 5 years, you have the required rate of return of 5%. Then for the next 5 years, you have the required rate of 10%. Then in the diminishing stage of your product life cycle, your required rate of return is just 4%. That's possible when you find the NPV. But is it possible when you find the IRR? No. IRR assumes that cash inflows and cash outflows both are reinvested again at the IRR. So a constant rate of return is followed over a period of time. IRR gives you an answer in 1%, right? Say 11%. What is the interpretation of this 11%? That is the exact rate of return, compounded rate of return you have got from the project. But sir, that 11% compounded growth rate of return, how can you assume that it will remain constant over a period of time? Which is quite an unrealistic assumption, right? Based on the expansion, programs of the company based on the product life cycle, based on the life cycle of the company itself, based on the promotional nature of the brand, your required rate of return from any project may vary on time to time basis, which will be considered effectively by NPV. NPV takes into account the different rate of returns over a number of years, but IRR ignores that. IRR gives you just 1%. That's why NPV is again widely followed. So there was one survey conducted among the finance fraternity that while evaluating the project, and that was also circulated to the industry experts, you know, and the finance managers across the companies, that which capital budgeting evaluation technique is used, followed most by company. So around 56 to 60% people, and that is a part of this textbook as well, that survey is taken as a one example in the textbook. You may check it over there in the Prasanna Chandra. So around 55%, 50% people were using the NPV. And then the second rank was of the IRR. So these two methods are widely followed, and in that too, NPV is better among these two. Well, so that's the comparison of NPV and IRR. I hope you people have got this. May I have a confirmation through the chat box that you have got everything till now? Any conceptual clarity you require for this, IRR and NPV? Received confirmation from Mr. Harsh, Miss Urja as well, nice. Mr. Neev too, amazing. Okay, I was repetitively saying this in the last lecture too, that please do not assume that you are not required to learn finance if you are selecting other specialization. Say if you are a HR manager, whether to buy an application screening software is a financial decision. You as an HR manager will be taking that decision, right? How do you evaluate that, whether to do this or not? What's going to be the projected inflows and outflows from that HR software? So you cannot eliminate this from whatever the specialization you select. Whether one particular marketing campaign should be done financially or not. What are the financial inflows from that campaign? What would be the potential outflows from that campaign? Those who are having the better exposure of accounting might be aware that there is something called a human resource management accounting as well now. Now, many of the companies have started doing that too. So you project your employees as an asset, and you find the discounted value of those employees, and you record it somewhere, that what is the discounted value of your employee, potentially an employee, how much that fellow is going to earn for you during the lifetime of his stay in this company. This is how the employees are recorded. That's where the discounting happens. Say that employee will earn for a company, say 10 lakhs rupees on a yearly basis, and we are going to spend 6 lakhs rupees of per annum package for them. So basically 4 lakhs rupees of additional inflow that employee will be generating for the company. Say that employee remains over there for 10 years. So 4 lakhs rupees for 10 years. What is the discounted value of that employee? That is the human resource accounting. So these things are applicable everywhere. Why this is a part of the second semester? Because this should be applicable to everyone. After third and fourth semester, the advanced subjects may not be required for everyone, but the second semester level subjects are required for everyone. Similarly, say if you are selling the financial product, how will you do the marketing if you don't know how to project a customer, how to present the need, you know, how to present your requirements to the customer, how to know their what they are thinking about this, how to know their perception towards that product. Accordingly, you will make your strategy for direct sales. Anyway, so these things are not exclusive in nature. These are interdependent things. Okay, let's move ahead. The last capital budgeting technique we are going to see today is the capital budgeting technique is the discounted payback period in the capital budgeting. Now you have heard about this payback period. Can someone tell me what was the payback period? What was the payback period? Can someone tell me?
Sir, may I?
Yes, please. Why not?
Sir, payback period is the time in which the initial investment is being taken off from that project or is being recovered from that project.
Very true. So, sir, it is a time period. This answer is in time period. It is a time period in which my investment amount is recovered back. Now, here in this case, if I ask you one more question, does this payback period consider time value of money? That was considered as the criticism while discussing the payback period earlier, right? If you can recall it. We were not considering the present value of inflows and outflows anywhere. Now, what does the NPV tell you? NPV tells you that, sir, at a specified rate, whether the project should be accepted or rejected. If you have specified rate of 5%, 7%, 10%, whether you should accept or reject it. Now, discounted payback period is the combination of NPV and payback period. How? I'll tell you. Now, that answer is in this question. The question is, if I tell you that in what year, in which year, in how many number of years, you are able to recover the required rate of return from the project. If I ask you that question, that is precisely the discounted payback period. Try to understand, I am reiterating that. How many number of years will be taken? How many number of years, months and days will be taken to satisfy the required rate of return? That means, when the NPV will become zero, that means the set required rate of return is satisfied, PVCI becomes equals to PVCO. That means the required rate of return is satisfied, right? So in what number of years the PVCI will become equal to PVCO? That is the discounted payback period. Discounted payback period. I can also state it like, how many number of periods, maybe in a year, months and days, will be taken to cover up your required rate of return? How many number of years, months and days will be taken to make NPV zero? How many number of months, days and years will be taken to make PVCI equal to PVCO? How many number of days, month and years will be taken to cover up your required rate of return? So there may be possible various analytical interpretations of this, you know. Or sabse layman language mein jinko kuch nahi samajh mein aaya, sir, discounted cash outflow ko hum kitne saal mein cover kar lenge? Discounted cash inflow, discounted cash outflow ko हम कितने साल में कवर कर लेंगे बाय डिस्काउंटेड कैश इनफ्लो? वेल, सो आई एम पुटिंग अक्रॉस द वेरियस पर्सपेक्टिव्स टू इंटरप्रेट इट. लेट्स गो टू द क्वेश्चन सो दैट वी विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड इन अ बेटर वे. प्लीज टेक अ क्लिक ऑफ दिस, स्नैप ऑफ दिस. दैट्स वेरी इजी. आई मीन इन द कैलकुलेशन इट वॉन्ट बी वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर यू टू अंडरस्टैंड. दैट्स वेरी इजी. इफ यू हैव अंडरस्टूड एनपीवी वेल, देन यू विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस एज वेल. But for this analytical and interpretation aspect, no, that's where a bit of intellect will be required. Okay, Mr. Ayushman Khurana wants to invest in one web series named Badai Ho. विच विल बी क्या, विच विल बी यहाँ पे कुछ है क्या? हाँ, विच विल बी रिलीज्ड इन एवरी सीजन इन ईच ईयर ऑफ नेक्स्ट 5 years. लेट मी जस्ट इंक्रीज द साइज ऑफ इट अ बिट. हाँ, फॉलोइंग आर द कैश आउटफ्लोज एंड इनफ्लोज इन द वेब सीरीज. So right now he would spend straight away 30 lakhs rupees, and then year number one he would spend 20 lakhs rupees. Then on a yearly basis, the inflows expected from this web series, say the every season of this web series will be out in each year. In the first year, 20 lakhs are expected, then 14, then 15, 16, 17 and 17. What is discounted payback period of this web series if required rate of return is 11%. Now you must have observed one more thing that is slightly out of the context. Let's see, you have first predicted the inflows and outflows. So this question may get raised in your mind that, sir, how did we predict this exact inflows and outflows? Now, my friends, there are various predictive techniques which may be used to predict the forecasted values. It may be regression, it may be multiple regression, it may be a time series model, it may be exponential smoothening, it may be Arima model in the time series. So there are various predictive techniques by using, you know, some statistical concepts like regression, correlation and time series models. Now, this is something which I'm not covering right now because that requires the advanced knowledge of FM, and that will be a part of, say, the financial analytics kind of a subject. So that may not be known to, say, an HR manager or a marketing manager. वो आपके उसके लिए कोई बात नहीं, उसके लिए तुम फाइनेंस एक्सपर्ट को हायर कर लो. लेकिन डिस्काउंटेड पेबैक कैसे फाइंड करना, दैट शुड बी नोन टू एवरीवन, राइट? इरिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ व्हाटएवर द स्पेशलाइजेशन वी सिलेक्ट. तो वो उसके लिए हम वहां पे बहुत ज्यादा डीप में नहीं जा रहे हैं. व्हाट इज द रिक्वायरमेंट, व्हाट इज द डिस्काउंटेड पेबैक पीरियड ऑफ दिस वेब सीरीज इफ रिक्वायर्ड रेट ऑफ रिटर्न इज 11%. वेल, द थिंग्स आर वेरी सिंपल. जस्ट ड्रॉ अ टेबल स्टार्टिंग विद द सीरियल नंबर, राइट योर कैश आउटफ्लो, राइट योर कैश इनफ्लो. Then you will find the discounting factor. Now, discounting factor for inflow as well as the outflow, both will remain same, right? So discounting factor is to be written only one time. So discounting factor at what percentage? Whenever you are supposed to find the present value, the rate of return requirement is compulsorily, mandatorily to be given to you. So 11%. Then we will find present value of cash outflow and present value of cash inflow. So with the discounting factor, if you multiply the inflow, it will be CI. If you multiply with outflow, it will be PVCO. So let's just write the serial number of all inflows and outflows here, starting from, I guess, 0 to 6. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. What are the outflows? 30 lakhs and 20 lakhs. Now, please do not end it over here. One more column will be required, which will be cumulative PVCI. Present value of cash inflow. If you can recall that payback period wala, over there too the cumulative was required, right? But instead of the simple cash flows, we'll be taking the present value of cash flows for this cumulative. Very easy, nothing to be worried about. Just write whatever I have there in the question. We'll solve it, don't worry. Vish Chaud Pandersol. सर आपने तो 7 कॉलम यहां पे बना ली, लेकिन हम वहां पे 7 कॉलम कैसे बनाए? बेटा कोई बात नहीं, चार ऊपर बनाओ तीन नीचे बनाओ, इसीलिए मैंने पहले टेबल ड्रॉ किया ना, 70 70 एंड सम विल बी लाइक तो हमें तो करना ही नहीं है, तो कुछ फर्क ही नहीं पड़ता है। करो करो तुम लोग मौज करो, फिर एग्जाम मैं लिखने जाऊंगा। 17 17 सर डिस्काउंटिंग फैक्टर विल रिमेन सेम फॉर 11%, सो 1 डिवाइडेड बाय 1.11। मे आई हैव द आंसर्स प्लीज? फॉर द फर्स्ट जीरो ईयर, प्लीज फॉर द जीरो ईयर द डिस्काउंटिंग फैक्टर विल ऑलवेज बी 1, बिकॉज जीरो ईयर माने के राइट नाउ इन द प्रेजेंट ओनली, सो डिस्काउंटिंग फैक्टर विल बी 1। फॉर द फर्स्ट ईयर व्हाट डू वी गेट? 0.9009 9009. Next one.
0.8116 8116.
Next one. 0.7312 7312. Next one.
0.6587 6587.
Next one.
0.5935 5935.
Okay, next one.
5346 5346.
Okay, so sir, we'll find the PVCO and the PVCA both in a different column. So PVCO first, you multiply that with the first, so it will remain 30 lakhs only, right? जैसे हमने बताया वन है ना, वो कौन सा नंबर है? नार्सिसिस्ट नंबर है। वन जिसको मल्टीप्लाई करता है तो वहीं के वहीं रहते हैं, जिससे डिवाइड होता है उधर भी वहीं के वहीं रहते हैं, सो इट्स अ वेरी नार्सिसिस्ट नंबर। ओके नेक्स्ट वन, 20 लैक्स मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 0.9009, व्हाट डू वी गेट? कैन समवन टेल मी प्लीज?
Eighteen zero one eight zero two.
Good. See, in the payback period, what we were doing, that we were finding that in how many number of years my investment will be recovered back. Right. So here, investment value you are taking, outflow is your investment only, but you take the present value. So you do just the total of this. Total kya aata iska? 30 plus 1801, so it would be 4801802. Let me put it in a different color box so that you are able to get it. So sir, in how many number of years the present value of cash outflow will be recovered back if we consider the PV CI instead of just the CI? So now we'll be finding the present value of inflows. Now the zero cell mein to inflow kuch hai hi nahi. In the first year, you have got the inflow, 20 multiplied by 0.9009. So that is again the same 1801802. For the third year, 14 multiplied by 0.8116. What do we get? Can someone tell me, please?
Sir, it's 1136271.
Very good. Next one, 15 multiplied by 0.7312.
1096787.
Okay, next one, 16 multiplied by 0.6587.
1050 3970.
Nice. Next one. 1008867. Okay, and the last one, 17 multiplied by 0.5346.
90888 9.4
90888
नाइन
नाइन ओके फाइन, पॉइंट को इग्नोर करते हैं, कोई जरूरत नहीं है. सो नाउ विल बी फाइंडिंग द पीवीसीओ, बिकॉज सी इन व्हाट ईयर दिस पीवीसीओ इज कवर्ड बैक इन टर्म्स ऑफ पीवीसीआई. सो वी आर सपोज टू फाइंड द क्यूमुलेटिव अमाउंट, राइट? सो देन ओनली विल बी एबल टू फाइंड दैट ओके इन बिटवीन दिस एंड दिस ईयर वी हैव कवर्ड बैक. सो लेट्स फाइंड द क्यूमुलेटिव अमाउंट. फॉर जीरो इट वॉन्ट बी एनीथिंग. फॉर द फर्स्ट ईयर द टोटल विल बी 1801802. Next one will be the total of first and second. What do we get? Can someone tell me, please?
Sir, it's 2938073.
2938073. Good. Add this 1096 into it, so we get cumulative for third one.
Forty thirty four eight sixty.
Really nice. Still, our 4801802 is not covered. I guess in this year it will be covered. So, what's the total of 4 year now?
50 888 30.
Well, now for the fifth and sixth year, you're not supposed to cover it back. No, I mean, even if you calculate, then it's perfectly okay, but not required, because now we have come to know that my payback period, discounted payback period, is falling somewhere between third and fourth year. Let me highlight that in a different color. So I can say now everything, all the calculations we were doing for payback period, no, the same calculations will happen. Everything will remain same. So we can say that, sir, it is something which is more than 3 years. Why? Because we are supposed to recover 48, and up to 3 years we have recovered 40. So payback period is something which is more than 3 years. Now, what is that something? So that formula was remaining amount to be recovered divided by denomination. Mein kya aayega, kaun batayega kya aata hai?
The total amount.
Total amount kidhar ka? Hint do, hint.
Total amount to be recovered. 48 less.
नहीं, नहीं.
Sir, it's NPV of both.
नहीं. देखो, मैं payback period में लेके जा रहा हूँ वापस. अब कुछ याद आ रहा है?
यस सर, आईआरआर कनेक्ट कर दिया.
सी, ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड इट, इट्स वेरी बेसिक मैथमेटिक्स. इसमें कोई ऐसा फैंसी रॉकेट साइंस नहीं है. देखो क्या है बेटा, आपने 40 रिकवर कर लिया, राइट? अब आपको 48 में से कितना और रिकवर करना बाकी है? So can someone tell me what is the remaining amount to be recovered after 3 years? In total, you have recovered 40,34,860. You are supposed to recover 4801802. So what is the remaining amount? Can someone tell me, please? What do we get? 4101802 minus 4034860. What is the remaining amount?
766941.
766941, right? Now that is the pending amount to be recovered. But in the entire fourth year, what is you are recovering here? In the entire fourth year, what you are recovering? 10,53,970. So, sir, 1 year will be taken to recover 1053,970. But our pending recovery is just 766,941. Then how much year will be taken for that? Now here in this case, we assume that the entire year's cash inflow will be evenly distributed. If it is higher in some months and lower in some months, then this will not give you the right answer. So we assume that over the number of years, over the number of months and days, my cash inflow is evenly distributed. Matlab har din wo same inflow ho raha hai. Right? So sir, if 1 year is to cover this 1053,970, if 1 year is taken, then to cover back the remaining amount of 766,941, how much year will be taken? So we do the cross multiplication, right? So 766,941 multiplied by 1 divided by 1053,970. So I had given you that in the form of formula. So what I told you, that remaining amount to be recovered divided by, this is the PVCI of fourth year. Now here in this case, it's a PVCI. Earlier it was just the CI, cash inflow of the fourth year, because it was not discounted one, right? Now it is the discounted payback period. So we are using the present values. So 3 years plus, I'm writing it now, 766,941 divided by 1053,970. What do we get in years? Can someone tell me, please? 3 point. बेटा चार डिजिट तक लो ना, तो थोड़ा सा 7276. Is it right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Now if you say someone that 0.7276 years में कवर कर लेंगे, तो कैसा लगेगा ना? He would be like, oh भाई निकल तो इधर से, चल पतली गली से निकल, पतली गली से निकल. Because no one understand this language, no? It needs to be converted into month. So sir, 1 year equal to 12 month, then 0.7276 year will be equal to how many months? So 0.7276 multiplied by 12. So what do we get in months? Can someone tell me? Cross multiplication.
Eight point seven three months.
Now again, 8 months is pretty much understood, but what is the meaning of this 0.73 month? तुम किसी को बोलो कि मैं है ना 0.73 month में तुम्हारा पैसा दे दूंगा, तो वो तुम्हें पैसा देगा ही नहीं, बोलेगा बुड़बक निकल इधर से. 0.73 month में equals to what? So sir, 1 month equal to 30 days. Then 0.73 month will be equal to how many days? Again, cross multiplication, 0.73 multiplied by 30 divided by 1. What do we get?
21.9.
So it can also be written like 22 days. Now in days, you may just approximate it, then fine. There is no need to go into number of hours and number of seconds and microseconds and miniseconds and nanoseconds. Time to humne banaye hue hai bhaiya, time horizon bane hue nahi hai. Wo Mahabharat mein aata hai na, main samay hu, anant samay hu. To ye 22 days, 1 days vagera humne banaye hue cheez hai. Iske baad mein tum thoda sa kar sakte ho, seconds vagera ko ignore. So my final answers will be 3 years. I'm taking this 3 red. Let me use a different color. This 3 year, then this 8 month, and then 22 days. So 3 years, 8 months, and 22 days is my discounted payback period. It is not the payback period, it is your discounted payback period. I hope you are getting it. What is this discounted payback period? Try to understand that again. Sir, in how many number of years, months and days you will be able to recover your required rate of return? That will be 3 years, 8 months and 22 days. So here my NPV becomes zero. After that, whatever the present value of cash inflows I'll get, no, that will be a part of my NPV addition. That will marginally add my NPV. So in 3 years, 8 months and 22 days, required rate of return is already satisfied. After that, whatever you get is bonus. Is it clear? May I have a confirmation from all the students, please? The discounted payback period is absolutely clear. Kiska combination hai? This is the payback. This is the combination of payback period and NPV. Okay, received confirmation from Urja, Jigar, Mohit, Priska, Mr. Neev. Nice to see that. Others, I'm assuming that they are getting. The silence I'm taking affirmatively. Main to positive banda ho gaya. मैं क्यों नेगेटिव सोचू कि नहीं आ रहा है? नहीं आ रहा होगा तो बोलेंगे. अपन के लिए तो ग्लास आधा भरा हुआ ही है, तुम लोग आधा खाली है तो समझना हो तो समझो. ओके, सो दैट्स इट फ्रॉम माय साइड एज फार एज दिस डिस्काउंटेड पेबैक पीरियड इज कंसर्न. आई डोंट वांट टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू कैपिटल बजटिंग कॉल्ड MIRR. दैट इज गोइंग टू बी द लास्ट कैपिटल बजटिंग टेक्निक इन दिस मॉड्यूल. दैट विल बी डन इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन. So as far as this session is concerned, that's it from my side. Please put your enrollment number as a mark of your attendance. If you have any queries or doubt or question, please let me know right now. Okay, don't forget to put your attendance, please, everyone. कुछ कुछ कछुए हैं जो सोए हुए हैं उनको उठाओ, बोलो कि attendance का time आ गया है भैया. मेरे को remove करने पड़ते हैं इधर से.